गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आत्मीय ग्रीन स्कूल. दिस इज आफरीन सैयद, योर इंग्लिश टीचर. स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड विद वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच, वी आर नाउ वेरी मच गुड विद अवर नाउन्स. वी आर गुड विद प्रोनाउंस. वी नो अबाउट एडजेक्टिव्स, वी नो अबाउट वर्ब्स, वी नो अबाउट एडवर्ब्स, एंड हियर वी आर विद प्रपोजिशंस. सो वट आर प्रपोजिशंस स्टूडेंट्स? दे आर बेसिकली अवर पोजिशन वर्ड्स. नाउ how we are always learning grammar session, what we do, we usually watch the video, and along with the video I go on explaining so that it become easier and simpler to make you study, and as well as it is easier to understand. Okay, so let's study what are preposition words.
Position words, prepositions. Do you know what a preposition is? A preposition is a word that tells us where a person, an animal, a place, or a thing is.
Yes, what is preposition? Preposition answers to the question that where a person, place, animal, or thing is. It answers to the question that where a person, place, animal, or thing is. Basically, it shows the position, it shows the location, it shows the place where our person, place, animal, or thing is.
In this way, preposition words connect a noun or a pronoun to another noun or pronoun.
What does preposition words do? Preposition words connect one noun with another noun, or they connect one pronoun with another pronoun. I repeat, what does the preposition words do? They connect one noun with another noun, or they connect one pronoun with another pronoun. Like in the first sentence, students, you can see that the sentence is, man is sitting on the horse. So it is answering to the question, where is the man sitting? So he is sitting on the horse. He is sitting on the horse. So it is making a connection between a noun man and another noun horse. Okay, now in the next sentence you can see, he is sitting on it. So here the pronoun he is being connected with the another pronoun it with the help of preposition on. I hope it is very much clear to you all.
Some examples of prepositions are on, in, under, and over.
Some examples are on, in, under, over. Of course, there are many preposition words. We'll learn about them, but these are few basic ones. Which are they? On, in, under, over.
In other words, on, in, under, and over are position words.
Yes, we can say in other words that they are basically position words. Who are basically position words? On, in, under, and over.
Let us now look at some uses of these position words. The book is on the table. Here, on tells us where the book is.
Yes, you can see, where is the book? On the table. So when book is in contact with the table and it is lying on it, the word preposition on is being used. The book is on the table. You can see in the picture that how book is lying. So whenever a person, place, animal, or thing is lying in such a way, then it is then the position is being showed by the preposition on.
So on is a preposition. The teddy is in the cupboard. Here, in tells us where the teddy is.
Yes, you can see that the sentence is the teddy is in the cupboard, and you can look into the picture which says that the teddy is lying inside the cupboard. So when teddy is inside the cupboard, we can say that the teddy is in the cupboard. Okay, So when it is inside, when it is in something, then we use the preposition in.
So in is a preposition. The rabbit is under the tree. Here, under tells us where the rabbit is.
Look, here you can see in the picture, and you can have a relevance with the sentence which says that the rabbit is under the tree, which means that the rabbit is sitting under the tree. He is under the shade of the tree. So here it is said that the rabbit is under the tree.
So under is a preposition. The cat is jumping over the chair.
Now students, look, when something passes on from something, like you can see the cat is passing over the chair, it is not on or it is not under, it is passing over it, then we use over. Okay, the cat is jumping over the chair. So when the cat is just passing over the chair, we are using the preposition over.
Here, over tells us where the cat is. So, over is a preposition.
Okay, I hope you understood. Now we'll understand it in more detail. This was basic knowledge about preposition. Let us revise again that what is preposition?
Preposition is a word that is used to link noun or pronoun with other words in the sentence. Link here means they provide relationship between noun and other words in any sentence.
Yes, it is a relationship between a noun and other noun, or a pronoun and other pronoun, or you can say a noun with any other word. Okay, so it shows the relationship
and thus makes the sentence complete. These other words may be noun, verb or adjective. Let's understand them with an example. The cat is running, and now where is it sitting? The cat is sitting under the table.
Here, the cat is sitting under the table. So here, the cat, our noun cat, and our table, that is also noun. So here the relationship between cat and table is shown by using the preposition word under.
Here, under is used to link table, which is a noun, and sitting placement of cat. If we do not use under and write the same sentence, it is the cat is sitting the table. We are not able to get what is the relationship between the sitting of cat and table. Using under, we are confirmed that cat is sitting under the table. Hence, under is a preposition here. Now, let's look into the types of preposition. These are divided into three types depending on three situations. When an event or thing happened, where the event or thing occurred, and in which direction the event or thing is happening.
Dear students, how it is divided? The prepositions are divided into three parts. First, when does it happen? Where does it happen? And in which direction did it happen? Okay. So, when, where, and in which direction? These are three types of the preposition. We'll learn about it.
The preposition that describe when an event happened are defined as preposition of time.
Yes, they are known as preposition of time. So, anything which answers to the question when, it shows the preposition of time.
Examples of them are in, on, at, before, after.
So what are the examples? In, on, at, before, after. In, on, at, before, after shows the preposition of time, that is when.
Look into some sentence example to make things Here, when my birthday falls, it falls in the month of January. In here is a linking word and hence is a preposition.
In the sentence you can see, my birthday falls in January. So it is showing the time that when does the birthday falls in January. So it is answering to the question when. So it is a preposition of time.
Preposition. My vacation ends on Monday. When my vacation ends, it ends on Monday. On here is a linking word and hence is a preposition.
Here, my vacation ends on Monday. So when does your vacation end? It ends on Monday. So here on is showing the time that when it is ending. Okay, so end is a preposition of time.
It gets cold at night. When it gets cold at night. At here is a linking word and hence is a preposition.
Yes, it gets cold at night. So it is getting cold at night. When does it getting cold? Answer to the question. When does it getting cold? It is getting cold at night. So what is answering to? It is answering to the question when, which is showing the preposition of time. Who is answering to the question when? At. If we are writing, it gets cold night. So we will not be able to understand the sentence. We will not be able to understand it in a complete sense. Whereas at is helping us to understand and it is helping us to know about the timing. So here, it gets cold at night worked as a preposition of time.
Remember that this preposition links when one thing happened in context to other. Now let's look into next one. The preposition that describes where anything is in context to other are defined as preposition of place. Examples of them include under, above, in, on, and at. Now you might be thinking, we had in, on, at as preposition of time and here also same, but please note they are used in different meanings. Let's see some sentence example.
Look students, now other one is where, that is basically preposition of place. Which are the example for preposition of place? Under, above, in, on, and at. Now don't get confused that here in preposition of time also we have used in, on, and at, and here in the preposition of place also we are using in, on, and at. Now in, on, and at can be used in different context. We have to see the context and we have to see the meaning that how they are being used. Okay, let's take an examples
to make things clear. The books are on the table. Now, where are the books placed? They are placed on the table.
The books are on the table. So, where are they placed? Where are the books placed? They are placed on the table. So, here on works as a preposition of place.
Here, on describes the link between table and books. Hence, it is a preposition of place. The plane is just below the cloud. Where is the plane with respect to cloud? It is just below.
Yes, the plane is just below the cloud. Now here you can see that the plane is below the cloud. Okay, look students, whenever thing is not in the contact with thing, when a thing is not in a contact with anything and it is in air and it is passing below something, then we'll use below rather than we using under. We'll use below when it is not in contact with anything. So here we can see that a plane is passing below the cloud. So here below shows the preposition of place.
Here below is a linking word. Remember, this preposition provides where the thing is with respect to another. Now let's look into the next type. The preposition that describes where to go or where to put something are called as preposition of direction. Some of the examples of them are to, into, of, from. Let me give you some sentences.
Yes, preposition which shows the direction are basically to, into, or from, which shows the direction, like towards which we have to perform. Let's take
example to make things clear. We went to London last week. Here, to describes in which direction we went. So, here to is the linking verb. We went up the hill. Here, up describes in which direction he went.
Yes, we went to London last week. So, it is showing that they have been moved towards London. So, here to is used to show the direction. He went up the hill. So, here it is shown that he went upside. He went up the hill. So, here up is showing in other direction.
So, up is a linking word here. Remember, this preposition provides in which direction the thing is in respect to another. So, these are the main three types of preposition. Now, let's look into one more term related to preposition. Prepositional phrase. What is the phrase? It is a group of words. And what is a prepositional phrase? It is a group of words containing preposition. Let me...
Yes. What are phrases? Phrases are basically group of words. And when we say prepositional phrase, that means a group of words which contains preposition. So, whenever a group of words contains preposition, then it is known as prepositional phrase. Sorry, students.
Give you some examples of it. The rabbit hopped through the garden. Here, through is a preposition and through the garden is a whole prepositional phrase. Let's see next one.
Students, the rabbit hopped through the garden. So, through is a preposition and through the garden makes the prepositional phrase because it is showing that where does the rabbit hop or towards what rabbit hop. Okay, so it is through the garden. It passes, the rabbit is passing through the garden. So it is showing the preposition, that is a position of a rabbit, and it is showing that it is passing through the garden. So through the garden forms the group of words containing preposition. Therefore, it through the garden is a prepositional phrase.
The balloon drifted up the stairs. Here, up is the preposition and up the stairs is the whole prepositional phrase.
Yes, the balloon drifted up the stairs. Here, up is a preposition and the entire group of words, that is up the stairs, form the prepositional phrase.
Let's look into one more example to make things even clear. The tiger crept slowly over the grass. Here, over is the main preposition and over the grass is the prepositional phrase.
Just like that, the tiger crept slowly over the grass. So here, over is a preposition and over the grass, that is basically group of words, forms the prepositional phrase. So students, you can see in all the three sentences, there is mention of a preposition. Like in the first sentence, you can see through is acting as a preposition. In the second sentence, you can see up is acting as a preposition. In the third sentence, you can see over is acting as a preposition. And when these are shown that where the first noun or pronoun is being connected with the other noun or pronoun, then those preposition forming the group with them forms the prepositional phrase. Like through the garden, up the stairs, over the grass, that forms the prepositional phrase. I hope it is very much clear to you all, students. Prepositions are position words and prepositional phrase are group of words containing preposition. Okay, so whenever there is group of words which contains preposition, it forms prepositional phrase.
So remember this, that prepositional phrase are group of words containing preposition. That's all about preposition in this video.
Okay, so that was a short introduction, I guess not a short, but a little bit lengthy introduction and understanding towards what are preposition. Let us see some more prepositions. Let us take some more examples about prepositions.
Above, below, in front of, behind. Above, below, in front of, behind. Keep on listening to the rhyme about above, below, in front of, behind. Now the bat is above.
It is a kind of poem to make it easier to understand and to make it easier to learn.
The cat, just like the cat, is below the bat. Now the bat is above the cat.
Look, students, the bat is not in the contact with the cat, but it is in the air. So we use above. The bat is above the cat. So it says the bat is above the cat.
Just like the cat is below the bat.
Just like the cat is below the bat. Over here you can see that the cat is standing below the bat.
And the rat is now in front of the cat. Just like the cat is behind the rat. And the rat is now in front of the cat.
Now, when the cat comes, when the rat comes in front of cat, we have used in front of. So in front of is a prepositional phrase which says the rat is in front of the cat, just like
cat, just like the cat is behind the rat.
The cat is behind the rat. It is showing the position. It is showing that where is the cat. So the cat is behind the rat, just like that the rat is in front of the cat.
Let's sing that one more time, but this time you sing with me. Now the bat is above the cat, just like the cat is below the bat. And the rat is now in front of the cat, just like the cat is behind the rat. Inside, outside, beside, between. Inside, outside, beside, between. Keep on listening, you'll know what I mean. Inside, outside, beside, between. Now the rocks are inside the box.
Look, the rocks are inside the box. Look, students, that the rocks are inside the box.
Now the rocks are outside the
box. Now, the rocks are outside the box. So inside and outside both are preposition.
Box, and the fox is beside the blocks.
Now, the fox is standing beside the blocks. So beside is a preposition. There are many prepositional words, students. So whatever, whichever word which shows the position is known as preposition. So here it is said that the fox is beside the blocks.
Now the fox is between the blocks.
Now the fox is between the blocks. When it is between two things, then we have used between. So between act as a preposition.
Okay, now sing that with me. Now the rocks are inside the box. Now the rocks are outside the box. And the fox is beside the blocks. Now the fox is between the blocks.
Great work, everybody. Let's review.
Above. Below. In front of. Behind. Inside. Outside. Beside. Between.
Okay, I hope it is very much clear, students. So there are many prepositional words. Okay, there are many prepositional words. So any word which is showing you position of the word, it is known as prepositional words. I hope it is very much clear. Now, what you have to do is, as usual, you'll open your grammar composition book, you'll read about preposition, and you'll solve the exercise of the preposition. Okay, students? Thank you so much, students. Have a very good day. Stay safe and happy.